Sample design is one of the key aspects about creating a research design. In this short video, we will quickly go through the concept of sample design. First, let us look at the meaning of sample design. A sample design is a definite plan for obtaining a sample from a given population. The sample design refers to the technique or procedure the researcher would adopt in selecting the items for the sample. Sample design is determined before data is collected, and there are many sample designs from which a researcher can choose. Now, there are certain terminologies such as population, finite, infinite, which needs to be understood to understand the concept well. One of the important concepts regarding sample design is universe or population, which is defined as all the items in any field of inquiry constitutes the universe or population. Let us consider that this rectangular box refers to the field of study. And how many units are present in here? That is the population. Suppose there are 3 units. Now the population is 3. Suppose we add more units. Now the universe or population is 6. And when we add 2 more, now it becomes 8. So universe or population refers to all the units which are present inside the field of study. Census inquiry or census survey refers to a complete enumeration of all the items in the population. What does this mean is that suppose we collect data from all the 8 units that is present in the population, then we are doing a census survey. The advantage of this survey is that we will get accurate information. But practically speaking, it may not be possible to do a census inquiry. Suppose our study is about the preference of a particular dish by the people of Pala. Then we will have to go to each and every person living in Pala and register their preferences to conduct the study, which will be very time consuming and very difficult to conduct. That is the disadvantage of census inquiry. That is why the concept of sampling exists. The next concept is sampling. Sampling refers to a situation wherein we will only choose certain unit from the entire population, and these few units should become a true representation of the population. For example, out of these 8 units, if we are only choosing the 4 unit, then what you are doing is called as sampling. Now the problem with the sampling is that if the units are not uniform, then the accuracy of the collected data will be less. There are 2 methods of sampling. One is non-probability sampling and the other one is probability sampling. Non-probability sampling is an easy method, but the accuracy of the data will be very less. With non-probability sampling, it is not possible to draw conclusion. Whereas, probability sampling uses advanced statistical techniques to evaluate the outcome. As a result, it has high accuracy. And the data which is analyzed using probability sampling are valid. Another important concept related to the sampling is finite and infinite. Finite means countable. For example, the number of cakes sold in a day, the number of customers who purchased a cake in a day, all these are countable. But infinite, which is represented by this symbol, means uncountable. For example, the taste of the cake. It is a qualitative data and it is not easy to count. The satisfaction level of the customer. Again, it is infinite in nature. Sometimes, even countable items will be considered as infinite if the number is really large. For example, suppose you are trying to find out the number of cake which is sold in last 5 years or 10 years, then it is going to become infinite in nature. Thus, from the above mentioned concept, we can understand the need for sampling. Sampling is required when the universe or population has infinite number of items. Sometimes it can be possible that if you try to do a census survey, the entire unit might be destroyed. In both these instances, a sampling is required to conduct the research. Now let us look at an example. If you have to take the survey of the attitude of BHM students in India, it is not practically possible to do a census survey. So here the population is becoming infinite. Another example, in case of any food product, it is not practical to taste all the individual items to ascertain the quality of the food item. We will always take a sample of the food in a particular batch to identify whether the entire batch is good or not. Here, in case of food products, if you do a census survey, that means you will have to taste every food, which will destroy the food. Thus, this is the need for sampling in research studies.